You was walking around this party like you don't know what happens when the sun goes down and the moon comes up. The blunts go round, everybody getting drunk all night. You know we put it down all night. Hey, we gon' fuck around all
wake
night.
Wake up in the morning and thank God, because I know that he blessed me. I know that he blessed me. Hop in my ride with my 45, hoping nobody out here tests me. I hope nobody gon' test me. Now you can brag about the money you got, but homeboy, that don't impress me. No, don't impress me. 'Cause I don't need drama in my life. Every day I'm trying to live it stress-free. Yeah, stress-free, stress-free. Stress free, oh, stress free, yeah. Stress free, stress free, stress free, ooh, stress free, yeah.
I'm stressing out right now because I don't know where my black pen went.
What's good, YouTube? That 182 here, back again once again. Today, people, today, we're here for episode number 30 for Pokemon Sun and Moon Let's Play. And today's episode is, in fact, going to be an hour of power! Ah! So if you guys are hyped for today's episode, and of course, if you're a proud member of the Happy Nation, make sure you smash the like button down below for us, because you already know your support is greatly appreciated. And of course, you know, can't nobody let's play a motherfucking game like the motherfucking Happy Nation can, goddammit. Now, fun fact for you guys. Everybody, I don't know, it hurts my head sometimes, because it's like, you guys knew, especially people like, I understand everyone on YouTube may not have known this, and I'll get back to that, but everybody that follows me on Instagram or Twitter knew that the first 29 episodes of this Let's Play, I had the chance to actually bulk record, because I went to Canada this last week. I actually got back on Wednesday. I'm recording this on Friday. It's gonna go up Friday night, you guys are gonna see it, but there is still such a large majority of people who knew that I had recorded 29 episodes, but still went around telling people that I had played through the entire game. And it doesn't make much sense, because it's like, if you're on YouTube and you didn't know that I had recorded 29 episodes, then why would you go around saying that I recorded the entire game? I don't know. Either way, I was fortunate enough to have access to the game early, so I was able to record 29 episodes. I tried to get 30 done, but I only got 29 done. And I have not recorded Sun and Moon. I haven't even played the game, like, continued progression in the game, because we're Let's Playing it in over a week. So I am beyond titillated and excited to record this today. Super duper hype, super duper excited. Let's get a quick team recap for you guys. Because I wasn't able to... Oh my god, look at our team. Because I wasn't able to... I want to come back down here and explore this, talk to the people in this building. But because I wasn't able to actually continue progression in the game... what I did do while I was in Canada, I went to Canada for a week, by the way, if you guys didn't know. I went to Canada to go see NXT TakeOver in Toronto, and I went. I was front row at WWE Survivor Series. I saw Goldberg's return and everything. And I went to Monday Night Raw afterwards, hung out with Mo for the entire week and whatnot. But if I hadn't had the chance to get the game early and pre-record, then we would not have had a Sun and Moon Let's Play. Period. I would be recording episode 1 for you guys right now. There was no way I was going to be able to record Sun and Moon while I was in Canada. I had everything that I needed to record it with. It's just my hotel internet was complete trash and garbage, so it's either here or there. But what I did was I swapped out, because I couldn't continue playing the game, I began shiny hunting. And I was trying to shiny hunt Stuffle, and I was trying to shiny hunt Crabrawler. I wanted to shiny hunt a Pikipek, and for the life of me, I was using SOS chaining and everything, and I could not get a fucking shiny Pokemon to save my life. I want to get a fucking shiny Stuffle. I might do that on Switch sometime soon. But just randomly, random encounter grass, didn't SOS chain or anything, got a shiny Trumbeak that I named Dr. Seuss. Now, I heard that Trumbeak evolves to 28, so if I continue shiny hunting, maybe in the next couple episodes we'll have a shiny Toucan just chilling here. But I named him Dr. Seuss because I figured it fit. Everyone names this thing Sam because it becomes a Toucan, but I wanted it to be different than Sam, and I figured Dr. Seuss fits, you know? Trumbeak and Toucan are goofy-ass Pokemon, so I figured it fit. Why not? But either way, I did do quite a bit of catching. I caught ourselves a Sandygast from the Hano Beach. It's called Shukaku. I found a Phantump on next to Tapu Lele's area. I got a Alolan Raticate as well. I did a lot of actual hunting around and catching mons and whatnot. I like how I named that Plumeria, and I had no idea where the name came from. It popped in my head. What Plumeria? What name is Plumeria? And it's the fucking Team Skull admin lady thing, my bobber. But yeah, I did a lot of hunting. I caught a Wimpod. I got a fucking Comfey as well. I'm just catching you guys up on the things that we've been doing. So I don't know, I'm just trying to generally catch mons that are in the area and around, but what I ultimately did was, because I was shiny hunting and I was killing mons in the SOS chaining way, our party started to get levels, and I was like, whoa, slow down, I don't want any more higher levels than what we actually have. So that's when I swapped out the entire party, and I picked up Precious and Dr. Seuss and Humongous, which now there's a whole movement to add Humongous back to the team. So it is what it is. I'm sorry this intro is super long. Like I said, I personally haven't played Sun and Moon in a week, so I need to get caught up on things, and I'm catching you guys up on things as well. So, let's get a quick party recap. And it's okay if we take a little extra time, because we have a fucking hour here today, goddammit. But at first, we have Cactus Jack, our Marini, which the Marini episode went up, and so many people just lost their minds. It's like, what's going on here, Nappy? This isn't a part of the Let's Play. This isn't where you're at. It was an episode that explained. It was like a filler episode almost. Like, imagine if the Let's Play is an anime. That was a filler episode. Like, I showed you how we got the Marini. Because I told you guys in the episode before that I was hunting a Marini and I was losing my mind. So the next episode, I showed you guys how we actually caught Cactus Jack. Because there's a whole bunch of people that are like, you didn't show us catching the Stuffle. You didn't show us catching the Pat Simeon. Because they're the rare encounters in that area. And you guys saw how long it took me to get the fucking Marini. We'd have been there forever trying to catch a Stuffle and a goddamn Passimian. So I caught them off screen. I explained it all in the next episode. But either way, we have Cactus Jack here, our Marini. And everyone lost their minds as well. They're like, Nappy, that's not how you use the Adrenaline Orb. And I'm just like, dude, you know it's pre-recorded. This whole thing with the Marini is like the second day I played the game. I did not know how to use an Adrenaline Orb then. Obviously, I do now, but either way, we have Cactus Jack, Armorini, level 32, holding the Eviolite with Scald, Bite, Toxic, and Venoshock. We have Gabriella Oricorio, who I need to give her the Sharp Beak back, but she's got Air Cutter, Feather Dance, Cedar Dance, and Baton Pass. Delilah, our Mudsdale, look at level 30 fucking 4. You can tell I was using her to Shiny Hunt. With High Horsepower, Rock Tomb, Double Kick, and Stomp, holding the Soft Sand. We have Frankie, our Brion, level 33, with Scald, Aqua Jack, Acrobatics, and Disarming Voice, holding the Water MZ. We have Rupert, our, Beware, level 33, holding the Quick Claw with Brick Break, Brutal Swing, Rock Tomb, and Takedown. We have King Julian, our Passimian, level 32 with Brick Break, Bulk Up, Acrobatics, and Rock Tomb. And everyone is incessant upon me slapping on different Z Crystals onto all these different mons. They're like, you should give Delilah the Fighting Type Zebu, because she has Double Kick. You should give Rupert the Fighting Type Zebu. And it's like, you can only use one Zebu per battle, so that would be like if you just ran with 6 Mega Evolutions and gave your whole squad Mega Stones. It's like, no, I would rather just rock out with one Z-move, since you can only use one Z-move, and let everyone else have an item that benefits them in a different way. To me, that makes more sense than to just slap Z-Crystal on all of them and just say, oh, well, maybe if we end up using it in this battle, we'll go ahead and use that. No, like, our Z-move is going to be Water MZ. Rocking out with that for right now. Until I change my mind, that's what we gonna have. God damn it. Where's the goddamn Sharp Beak? There we go. Give to that Pokemon. You guys see how many Adrenaline Orbs? I bought 99 of them. Because I was that's all I could do when I was in Canada. Like, in our downtime, only thing I could do, because I wanted to play Sun and Moon, only thing I could do was fucking Shiny Hunt. And when I'm trying to find a Shiny, I don't get it. When I'm not trying to find a Shiny, I get the fucking, whatchamacallit? It's popping with your Corsola. I get a fucking Shiny Trumby. So it is what it is, but we're here for episode number 30, back on track with things. It's been a little while, but we're here for episode number 30, and there are some people that are like, oh my god, Nappy, you're taking so long, and it's like, oh my god, I told you that in like episode 14, I'm gonna do every fucking thing in the game, I'm talking to everybody, let me do this shit, bitch. Like today, the islands of Alola are all quite far apart from one another. You wear out your poor Pokemon if you made them go that far, you have to take the ferry. How about you not tell me what to do? How about that? Did you ever think about that? How about you just sit in your fucking corner and just suck butt? Two great peaks tower over Ula Ula Island, Mount Hakulani and Mount Lanakila. Do you know that the snow falls on the peak of Lanakila even in the height of summer? Yeah, that's dope. Wait, did they both say the same thing? Oh. Welcome to Mali City. Mali? Mali? Mali City? Is that how you pronounce it? I was going to say, but today we need to get new threads, my dudes. We need to get new threads. Probably going to go to this little garden thing here and speak to Kukui and Hao. That's the last thing I remember. that we needed to do. I'm going to speak to them. When your Pokemon evolve, do you think they feel like, yes, finally? Ula Ula Island is so big that riding on Pokemon doesn't always cut it for everyone. A lot of people take the bus, too. Ula Ula Island. I didn't think Ula Ula was that big. So, seriously? I just got a Mewtwo through Wonder Train. Oh, well, lucky you, cunt. You know, these times you do nothing, just lays about, they can be a really beautiful thing. You right. You are right. I want you guys to know that while I was in Canada, I caught a cold. I have a sinus infection. I don't know if you can hear it in my voice. Oh, this chick is right here. I don't know if you can hear it in my voice, but my whole head is like throbbing and pounding because it's just packed full.
Nappy, it's been a while since I last saw you around, but weren't you supposed to meet the professor in Mally Garden?
Fine! It's time to stop! I like the music here. I like the music here. Ooh.
You get Pokemon here. Pokemon's.
Oh god, I haven't done this voice in a week.
Hey, Nappy, I heard that they serve tea somewhere here in Mally Garden. I'll start my search from the bridge here. Why don't you start around the edge of the garden?
Why don't you start? Why is everyone trying to tell me what the fuck to do? So he's blocking the bridge, essentially. We can't go over there. So
where's the professor? He's the one who told us to come here, yeah?
So we can't go across the bridge. He wants us to go around. It's a map of Mally Garden. Apparently there's some kind of motif. Can I go? No, there's an actual force field barrier. So what can we catch in Mally Garden? Oh, this little chick wants to battle? Oh, a luxury ball. Oh, yeah! Come on, come get this fucking work. Today is Pokemon Day. Every day is Pokemon Day, god damn it. Giggity god fucking damn. But still, one thing I did want to say, I know you guys may have seen the fucked up vlog that I uploaded from Canada, which again, I don't understand how everyone just made this assumption. Assumptions make an ass out of you and me, except not me in this situation, but maybe I'm assuming that people would understand. Yeah, you know, assumptions make an ass out of you and me, let's just go with it. But, okay, I uploaded the vlog and everything saying that, hey, I'm in Canada, 29 episodes have been recorded, this and that. And people still got this impression that I recorded the entire LP. And I'm just sitting there like, And I just love how, like, now that people have gotten into the game, they're realizing how good of a Pokemon Marini and its evolution are. And I'm like, that was me! Me! I said it! I fucking said it! And as far as I know, we're the only person that's actually using a Marini in our Let's Play. Everyone's using Marini, and I don't want to spoil its evolution for anyone who hasn't seen it yet, but everyone's saying that Marini is, like, such a good Pokemon. It's one of the best 7-gen Mons competitively, and this and that, and yada, yada, yada. And it's like, I knew that from the fucking start. I fucking knew it. Just let me have this, okay? That happened with Diggersby, too. I was the only person in X and Y that used a Diggersby, as far as I remember, in their Let's Play. And no one gave a shit about Diggersby until Shofu did his Diggersby video, which... I'm not hating on him. I love Diggersby. So any more shine that the Pokemon could get, I'm down for it. But it's just like, I was the only person that used it. Everyone fucking hated on Diggersby when the game first came out. They said it looked stupid. It looked fucking dumb. But your boy knew. He had faith the entire time. So is it just Poliwags? Is that the only thing that's here? Don't tell me it's just Poliwags.
Yeah.
It's just Poliwags, alright? Fuck this shit. I actually changed my 3DS time back as well, because before I went to Canada, and I was trying to record like 6 episodes a day, I can't get away. Poliwags, stop being a cunt! But I was recording a lot of the times from like 7 to like 1 in the morning or some shit. So because of the way the games are set up, it would be like, well, sun is like a regular clock. So everything would be like, oh, what the hell is this? The water sure is clear here, huh? I wonder if there's a Pokemon hiding in the shadows of the rocks or something. Why do they not want us to go... Oh, wait, no, that's fly. I don't want to fly. Why do they not want us to go into the middle? They want us to go all the way the fuck around. What is up? What's going on here? I know what, I'm not falling for these fucking tactics, you losers. You fucking losers. What was I saying just now? Oh my god! I haven't actually seen one of these in-game before. That's what Dupiter evolves into. Araquanid. Bro! Araquanid, however you want to say it. Yeah, I guess it would be Araquanid, because you don't say Arachnid. It's an Arachnid. Araquanid. Why do I keep saying it? It's because Aqua. Araquanid. Araquanid. There we go. Whatever. I still think his design is dope. Bro, it's such a cool looking Pokemon. That's wild. That's fucking wild. No, you can't save yourself, my dude. I'm catching this thing. I don't care. I'm catching it. You can't save yourself, my dude. The Toxic will whittle you down. It will whittle you down. I just don't want to hit him with a Venom Shock, and it takes his HP so damn low. No, just flinch. Just flinch, my dude. What's the problem? Just flinch. You're stupid. This is why you need a trainer. That's why wild Pokemon need trainers right here, because they're too stupid to fucking know on their own that, hey, I shouldn't go for this move again.
Oh, no!
Excuse me. Alright, so let me, I'm actually gonna use my... Oh, shit. Is that what it is? Oh, no. I'm getting that mixed up with a netball. Net and nest are two different things. I'm getting it mixed up. Oh, but I was saying, I changed my 3DS time back so that when it's during the day, now we're actually recording during the day. Catch that Pokemon. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Araquanid. I like that. 7th Gen Mons are dope. They are really fucking dope. Araquanid's data will be added to the Pokédex. It's crazy. I dislike spiders so much in real life, but in Pokemon, they're dope. I love Galvantula. I love Araquanid. Yo, look at the fucking Pokédex. Your boy has been out here! Ah! It delivers headbutts with the water bubble on its head. Small Pokemon get sucked into the bubble where they drown. Wow. Wow. Alright then, let's relax. What are we gonna call her? I'm gonna call her... No. What is the name of the chick from Code Geass? No. Her name was literally just CL, wasn't it? Wasn't her name literally just CL? From Code Geass? I just remember because she had green hair, and this nigga's all green. That's what she was, right? Let me see here. Code Geass. CL. Her name was CL, right? Oh no, her name was CC. What? Who am I thinking of as CL then? You know what? I'm just gonna call it Geass. I hate... Fuck! I'm gonna call Geass instead. Fuck it. I can't do anything right. Send to the damn box. I can't do anything right in life. I'm just ruining this Let's Play. I'm ruining Sun and Moon for everyone. I just wanna be able to breathe. I need to take Sudafed after I finish this recording. What in the world is the secret of the pond in this garden? Wait, can we fish? No, you can't. No, you can only fish in the little spots. Like that. Yeah. What do we got here? I swear on everything, if you have Magikarp in this goddamn pond, nothing. Nothing. Nothing at all. Yeah. I want to get to this fucking garden because I want to change my outfit. We're on Ulu Island. We need a new goddamn outfit. Damn it. We need a new outfit. They really were not lying when in Magikarp's Pokemon description. They said you were going to get fucking tired of seeing this damn Pokemon. They were not kidding. And speaking of seeing a new Pokemon, the past couple episodes, a lot of people have been saying that they've been missing our first child and that we should use Frankie more. So let's go ahead and slide Frankie up front. Let's use Frankie until she evolves. Or until he evolves, I should say. Look at this. We're on the other side of this fucking pathway you wouldn't let us go through. Why? Why do they make us walk all the way around? Hey, Hal. I'm on the other side of the fucking bridge, you stupid bitch. Wouldn't let me walk over there, asshole. Yo, wait. Wait, what about that side? Wait. I want to see what's on that side. Can I? I can't call. Fuck! We have to walk all the way back. I want to see what's on the other side of the garden. I thought they just both connected, but update! They don't connect. Ooh, we got to that grass without encountering anything. That's dippity fucking dope. Yeah. I want to see what's over here. Yeah, it says no ride Pokemon. That's so dumb. Why can we not ride? I hear Psyduck cries. Oh, or Slowpoke. That's what I meant. Same thing. Slow. No, that's a Psyduck. What the fuck? That's a goddamn Psyduck. I hear Psyducks. You can catch Psyducks here. Nigga, what the hell is you looking for? An ass whooping? Because I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you, my dude. I will give it to you. All you gotta do is ask. This nigga. Sightseer Mitch. Is that a Note 7? My dude. I don't know if you heard, being out here on Ula Ula Island and everything, but Note 7s are kind of explosive. They're kind of explosive. Yo, look at Frankie! That's my... Blow him away. Blow him away, Frankie. Oh. That's my child! That's what I meant to say before. Frankie, that's my child. That's my child, Frankie. Back the fuck up off. Stupid ass. Yeah. Hit him with that Hydro Vortex one time. Hit him with that Hydro Vortex one time. That full force Z move. I haven't seen this in a week. I'm so excited. Nah. And I can't wait for Nintendo to release our claim on our All Z-Moves video. I don't know if you guys saw it on day one, we had all Ultra Beasts and all Z-Moves go up, but the Z-Moves video is gone now because of Eevee and Primarina. For whatever arena, Primarina's Z-Move is blocked worldwide because it's included in the Japanese trailer. It's fucking stupid. It's fucking stupid. And I don't understand why it's just Primarina. Like, Incineroar and Decidueye's Z-Moves are in that trailer too. And they're in the Z-Moves video, but it's not blocked for that. It's just Primarina and Eevee. So, we're just shafted. Just, Nintendo just loves shafting people. For no fucking reason. No reason at all. No reason at all. What did I say? What did I say? Give me that money, my dude. Give me that money. That money? Money. What? It evolves to level 34? I wasn't ready. I'm not ready for this. I was just talking about Primarina. I wasn't ready for this. Oh, you wasn't ready! Bro, my child! My child, I can't call- Ah! I can't call her my child anymore. She's all grown up. That's wild. It evolves at level 17 and then evolves early at 34. I always thought they should change the evolution level of starters. I think they should make it like level 20 and level 40, or like 25 and 50 if you want to make it difficult. I think that should be, because like, I was like, if you think about it, like Pokemon can go up to 100 levels and a third of the way through, we're done. No more evolutions. We have Primarina for the next 60 levels. Haha. It controls its water balloons with song. It only weighs 97 pounds? That's a skinny bitch. The melody is learned from others of its kind and is passed down from one generation to the next. Bro. Ah! Look at her! Frankie wants to learn the move Sparkling Aria. Should a move be... Well, what does Sparkling Aria do? Isn't that her signature move? I think it's her signature move. Base power 90. The user bursts into song, emitting many bubbles. Any Pokemon suffering from a burn will be healed by the touch of these bubbles. Huh. What do we get rid of? Oh, it is water fairy. What do we get rid of? I kind of want to get rid of Aqua Jet, but it's priority, and her speed's not all that great. Huh. Acrobatics is for those grass types. But, you know, I'm going to get rid of Acrobatics for right now. Because the TM, we can relearn it, and we're holding the Water Gym Z as it is, so we're not getting the full effect of Acrobatics. I just taunted Acrobatics because, what do we have, like Bubble or Growl or some shit at the time? So we have Sparkling Aria. Oh, the Aria is a hotel in Las Vegas. Pretty fucking dope, swaggy hotel, if I do say so myself. Yo, I want to see my child's all grown up. Frankie. That cry. Yo, that backhand, though. Try her. Please try her. I call it her because she looks so feminine. But try him. Please try him. It's a merman. Yeah! I'll take it. I love it. So we're still waiting on Cactus Jack to evolve, which I think Cactus Jack may, in fact, evolve very soon. But still, I want to explore this side of the garden. So let me go, damn it. Oh, there's a fishing spot. Should we fish? Or is it just going to be grassy seed? What the fuck is a grassy seed? Should we fish or is it just going to be another Magikarp? What is a grassy seed? An item to be held by a Pokemon. It boosts defense on grassy terrain. It can only be used once. Is that a new item for 7th gen? I don't remember that being in 6th gen. I've never heard of a grassy seed before. But we did come back over here. There's another fish spot. Hot damn. We did come back over here to check that out. So let us continue and slip and slide back over here. It's so obnoxious that you can't use your ride Pokemon here. We would be gone by now. We'd be fucking blow this joint and get the fuck up out. But oh no! Oh no, you can't ride your... Probably because he doesn't fit. Tauros doesn't fit along here. But you should at least be able to ride like your Stoutland. You can sniff out all the grassy seeds. All the assy seeds. Assy McGee. So what's up with this? Oh shit, that's Kukui. It's popping, bro. There's an item over there.
Kakashi! Oh wait. Oh, Professor Kukui! Hey there! What's going on with you two? Your eyes are shining extra bright today. Did something big happen?
It sure did.
Professor, you got to hear this. The Ultra Wormhole opened up, like, right in front of us, and there really are Ultra Beasts in there. You gotta tell Professor about that, too.
Whoa! You got to see the Ultra Wormhole and an Ultra Beast. This is amazing! Oh, yeah!
Yo, he is such, like, obviously he's the masked Battle Royale dude, but he makes so many wrestling references. He says woo like Ric Flair just now, and oh yeah like Randy Savage.
Oh yeah, it's the Macho Man. Sounds like an even better reason to train hard. Yeah, on your island challenge. Maybe someday we'll all be able to go through the Ultra Wormhole. Alright, your next trial is up on Mount Hokulani. You can catch the bus to get there. Just head to the bus stop on Route 10, yeah.
You guys can go ahead without me, Professor. I've got a hot date with a Malasada shop. Visiting every last one of them is my own personal island challenger.
Roger that, good buddy. I'll be waiting at the bus stop, Nappy, whenever you're ready to go.
So why the fuck did we come in this park?
Hey, Nappy, did you know?
Know what?
There's an observatory on Mount Hokulani. And you know what it is they do at an observatory, right? Hope you do, cause I sure as heck don't. Now I'm out. I just want some Malasada. Goodbye, Nappy.
Excuse me. This place kind of reminds me of the Johto region. This how do you pronounce it? Mali City? Is it just that straightforward? Is Mali City? Is he referring to Ecruteak City? Is that why it reminds him of it? Huh? So that's it. I thought it felt kind of exotic. I heard this garden was designed by people who came here to Alola from Johto. A Rage Candy Bar. Convenient. All the Johto references and we find ourselves a Rage Candy Bar. And so apparently I also found out that when you see that the ripples in the water like that, it ups your chances of finding a rare encounter. Which would have been nice to know when I was hunting Marini. But again, I did that like the second day after people got the game and no one knew. Oh, it's such a rare encounter. Oh, such a fucking rare encounter. Such a rare encounter. Yo, look at Frankie! Frankie, I'm in love with you. I'm not fighting this thing. Get away. Go away. Go away. Go away. Go away. Frankie, I don't know what to say. Like, I can't say Frankie's our child anymore. Because Frankie's literally all grown up. Like, what are you supposed to say about your child when they grow up? I mean, I guess you could still say that's my child. That's my child. That's my boy. That right there, that's my boy. That wild arachnid. A wild arachnid. There we go. Arachnid. Ha 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 ha. Arachnid. Found a big mushroom. A big mushroom. Alright, let us slip and slide. Tay fuck up out. Oh, hell. I didn't even get a chance to... Alright. But you know what? It's Frankie's time to shine. Frankie's about to whip that dick out. That's actually what it is. That's actually what Frankie's tail is. Like, watch. When Frankie comes out... Oh, right now, just watch. Wait, there comes the Eradicate. It's an oh shit, look at that, it's an actual Eradicate, it's not a little one, she's a sightseer. Now look at Frankie's tail, look, oh my god, you see the little thing that's sticking out at the end? That's Frankie's dick. I just want you guys to know that. That's Frankie's actual penis. Why do we have three Zemus? What? Why is there three Zemus now? His base power's 175, okay. I don't know why we have three Zemus, but you know what, we're gonna rock out with it. Oh, you're gonna use Hyper Fang. For that, Raticate, you're going to be punished. You're going to be absolutely annihilated. Come, right now. Bring that ass here, boy. I smell the cooked Raticate. Ah! Woo! My own nipples hurt. Get up out. Get up out. Right you? Oh, hell no. We about to get up out. Get up out. It's been real and it's been fun, but we out this bitch. I think we're going to train Frankie up to 35 and then get everyone else up to 35 as well before we continue on. Because I don't think the experience share is on right now. I don't think it is. That'll be our next goal. We'll get everyone up to 35 and then we'll turn the experience share back on. Yo, check out this Raichu. Check out the young PK Sparks. She has a regular Raichu too, not a Alolan one. How has an Alolan Raichu? I think that's so dope. That's such great storytelling on Game Freak's behalf. Like, all the tourists, the sightseers who aren't from Alola have the original Mons. But in Alola, you would have the Alolan forms. That's dope. I like that. That makes them a dope trainer class, to be honest. It's alright. I disclosed everything. Everything about my Pokemon. When you came through customs? Is that what you're trying to tell me? It's alright, Delilah. I got you. Go ahead, close your eyes. I know you can't move because you're paralyzed. But you need to realize that you're special in my eyes. Delilah, you're all grown up. Here, have a bean. And I hope you get that nut. Alright, let's stop talking. Yo, Delilah loves us! Ah! Yeah. Here, since you're a big, growing Clydesdale, go ahead. Get you another bean. Mmm. Oh, it tastes so good, doesn't it? Oh, I know. I know, Delilah. I know! You're tired! I don't know, today's just a singing episode. Like, it's any different from any other episode. I don't know what's wrong with me. I'm just sick. I'm sick and my head just is pounding, so it's like whatever comes to mind just comes out of my mouth. Not like that's any different for any of the time. Oh shit! Lady Yen? come, Lady. Come. It's time for you to catch this Aqua Jet. And as far as I know, we're almost done exploring. Jesus Christ! Alright, you tried. We'll give you effort points for that one, Ladian. We'll give you effort points for that one, but just get in the ball. Let's just get in the ball. Just get in the ball. What? It didn't like me mocking it. It didn't like me mocking its efforts. Alright. Again, you tried. I bought 99 Ultra Balls as well. For my shiny hunting efforts. But you tried. Get in the ball. Get in the ball now. Just get in the damn ball. Stop fucking with me and get in the damn ball. Thank you. I appreciate that. Made me waste my goddamn Ultra Balls. Imagine if they made it so that you only use an Ultra Ball when you captured a Pokemon. Which, I don't know, that's a really weird, like, logistic to the game, I guess. Like, because you throw a Pokeball and a Pokemon breaks out of it, the Pokeball is now somehow rendered useless and can never be used again. So, ideally, Pokeballs are just one-time use, right? While it's believed that Starlight provides it with energy, this Pokemon also loves to eat berries. In the daytime, it curls up in the grass to sleep. Oh. Well, we're in the daytime right now. That nigga tried to beat the shit out of me. Tried to beat the absolute shit out of me. What are we gonna name this thing? What do you name a ladybug? Fun fact, when I was a kid, and I played through Silver and Gold version for the first time, I used to think Ladybug was the most dopest, amazing Pokemon ever. Not Ladybug, Lady Inn. Because I had a Ladybug, you know, I just random ass encounter and I caught it. And I evolved into Ladybug and I thought it looked so... I evolved into Lady Inn and I thought it looked so awesome. I used it all the way up to like the 7th gym. I'm just like, alright, I can't do this anymore. I'm trying, but even young me knew it was a bad Pokemon. So I'm going to name this thing... Name it Hillary. I'm gonna name it Hillary. Not after Hillary Clinton or anything like that, but just it's just Hillary. I don't know why. It's just I don't know what to name it. I don't really ever use a lady in. I used it once in my life when I was a kid. But after that, I just lady in fell out of favor with me. Oh shit! I guess it's a good reason we did come up here. Hot fucking damn. Is this like a alright. Never mind. Another goddamn lady. I was gonna say, is this like a mountain or something? I thought it was gonna be like a hut that was up here at the end. Like there was gonna be some reason for us to venture all the way up here. But I guess there is absolutely no reason for us to venture all the way up here. No reason at all. Yeah, I guess it's like a mountain that's up here. Cause I'm looking at like the bottom screen, the mini map, and it looks like a little hut or something, but it's not jack shit. Update! It's not jack shit. Still, I like this little area. I like that the game has made, like, separate areas within, like, the city actually feels large. You know what I mean? Because, like, there's different parts to it. It's not just this small little shitbag of a town. And they said that Haoli City or whatever it was on the first island was the largest city in the fucking region. But I feel like this city's much bigger. Maybe it only feels like that because of the garden, but still, I don't think Haoli is the biggest city. Because even Haoli didn't have much to it. It had two streets and the fucking pier. And that was that. So, like, how are you going to tell me that that's the largest one when there's not anything to it? Like, what? 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 Can I go now? Oh, there's a Ziggurat. The Ziggurat, it's right there. It's right there. Nappy, would you mind if I asked you something?
Shut up, Cosmog. She just elbows the bag. Shut the fuck up.
You want to go to the ruins? Or is it about Nebby?
Yes! I want to take Nebby to visit Ula Ula's ruins, but they are located deep in a large desert. I don't want to ask that much of you. Right now, I'm planning to visit Mali Library. There's a book that I want to look for there. Maybe you'd be willing to help me? I know that Mali Library is here within the city of Mali somewhere. Even I should be able to find it. I can do this!
So it aggravates me so much. She has a Pokemon that she will not put in a Pokeball, but she'll put it in a fucking bag that looks like a goddamn Pokeball. Suck that Ziggurat up! Hey! It's popping. What?
Professor!
Ah! It's a nigga Oak!
Why, hello there, Rotom! Are you feeling nice and comfy there in that Pokédex of yours? Never been better.
Oh my god. This has to be like some kind of levels of like racism. Cause this is Professor Oak in blackface. It's literally blackface Oak.
Oh, well, hello there. Good to meet you. I'm Oak, Samson Oak. I'm a Pokemon researcher, and I'm looking into the regional variants found around here. And you must be Nappy, huh? Young Kukui mentioned you to me. Rotom, you be sure to help this fine young boy on his trip around the islands, alright?
What do you think you're talking to? Well, who do you think you're? Of course I'm gonna do that.
And you, Nappy, I'll be trusting you to keep Rotom safe as well. The young fellow from Kalos who helped invent that Pokedex put a lot of work into it, and as much love and care as any parent. I'll be in the Mali Library if you ever need me. Feel free to stop by and chat anytime. If you're having trouble finding the library, just follow the Black Brick Road. Meaning the patterns on these paths, of course. Black circle, black triangle, black square. Follow that pattern and it'll get you there.
Yo. Black oak, black brick, and he rhymes. That's a Pokemon. Ah! Excuse me. I'm not falling for that. Black oak bullshit. Samson Oak, my asshole. What is it? I can't. Okay.
Hey there, Whippersnapper. Did you know that Quick Link lets you connect to somebody nearby in a flash? Though you never might. Excuse me.
I just can't win.
Hey.
Okay, so I want to explore a little market here before we leave. I want to explore. We can use this episode, our extended episode for this.
Welcome, thanks for coming. What can we offer you?
I'm here to eat. And I'll show you the menu. Please choose from these items. Each item costs 4,000. Z, what? Z, Kaiseki? Ninja set? Samurai set? Geisha set? Ronin set? Let's do ninja. We'll make you the ninja set, okay. Okay, I'll bring the food. What is this? We ate in Koni Koni. Z Kaiseki, sorry to interrupt. Chow the fuck down, my dude.
The main reason I want to do this is because I want to find the clothes shop. The grilled teriyaki is full of flavor and just the right amount of oil. Fantastic. The pickled vegetables are well seasoned and provide the perfect refresher between bites. Mwah! It's delicious.
Mmm. So what item do we get for this? You get 4 hard skills. Well, shit. Hot fucking damn. What's poppin' with you, Stuffle? Young Stuffle. Young Stuff. That's cool that they give you items like that. The wash basins they keep in Pokemon Centers have been infused with some of Kunfei's own healing components. That's why they smell so good. Delmize creates whirlpools to suck in and catch other Pokemon. What the hell is a Delmize? Fishermen in Alola have learned to target its whirlpools to catch Pokemon there, too. What is a Delmize? Bruxious is a Pokemon that puts fear even into the Pokemon like Sharpedo. That's why lifeguards on the beaches often help out and get helped out by Bruxious, because they help keep the beaches safe. Boy, that takes me back to the days of my own youth spent in the beach. This place makes you feel like a high roller.
Oh, I get it! Sushi High Roller!
I visited a restaurant with the same name in Kalos one time. Suddenly I want to drink tea. I can't get around to you. Come here. Please trade my Happini for your Pancham. No. Maybe next time. Happini for Pancham. So she wants a Pancham. I'll show you a Pancham. Please, Pancham.
Nuts! In your mouth! In your mouth hole, nigga.
Oh, it's the Malasada shop.
The Malasada!
You're sitting in my seat, bitch. Your Pokemon's bellies are completely full. They won't take a bite of Malasada from you. But I can't claim the same for myself. Ha! But I'm fine with that. I've got Gusto and I love it. The firefighters in Alola don't just put out fires, we also deal with the emergencies out at sea, so we're full of surfers too. Rough. It takes an adult to appreciate both the bitter and sweet parts of life, but then, if my Pokemon likes bitter Malasada and I don't, does that mean this little pup is more mature than I am? No. It's already been proven that just because a Pokemon evolves doesn't mean it's mature. Oh shit, it's time! It's time! Ooh. Can I borrow a moment of your time? Just a moment, mind you.
Sure.
Thank you very much. A moment to speak of our Lord and Savior, Arceus. You see, I've fallen in love at first sight with a Pokemon called Togedemaru. I love it to bits. I love it so much that I can't bear to even catch one for myself. I love this theme. It's the best one in the game. I don't care. so I wanted to ask a favor. Could you catch Togedemaru for me and then show me its Pokedex entry so I can see it? I think you'll find some adorable Togedemaru around the power plant. Its pointed little needles are just so adorable that I'm sure you get it as soon as you see it. And I promise you, if you're worried you to do this, so he wants a Togedemaru, which we're gonna catch a Togedemaru anyway. I'm guessing it's a rare encounter. Why is the clothes I want to wear are the clothes that actually suit me? And I also found out, you guys, too plain. You've got to deck yourself out in as much color as a muck or you'll just look old. First off, you old stupid bitch. I am decked out in the colors of a goddamn Alolan muck, stupid. Yo, get your wife some glasses. Hold you. Tell your wife to watch her fucking mouth before I go in on her. When you think of jumpsuits as clothes that are designed to get dirty, doesn't it make you love it that much more? Yo, bro, is that a Mario outfit? Is that an Easter egg? That's Mario's outfit on the wall. Haha. Yeah, yeah. All right, we need a new outfit for this this island. As much as I love our swaggy Alolan muck outfit, we need a sea cucumber? Light blue cutoff jeans. What, it's a, this island, we're all about cutoff jeans? Is that what this is? Camo? Ribbed capris. What? Yeah, yeah. But I also found out that apparently in Sun, you have pink clothing, and in Moon, you have purple clothing. So I've been talking this whole time, like, I would love to have purple clothing. We'll never get purple clothing. As much as that sucks, we'll never get purple clothing. Let's go with the fruit, because that seems to be the only thing they have here, at least. I'm sure in some other town, they'll have a different designs, because like we didn't get the black shoes and the black backpack till Coney, but we are dressed the fuck out to impress. Jesus. Only reason I'm going with this all pink is because it's so different. It's so different from our last outfit. Like that's pink, but I like the red ones better. The red ones match better. I'm getting the red ones. Man, clothing costs so much money, bro. Yo, should we go with the all? Oh shit! With the black backpack? How do you turn the, oh. Wait, oh that's white. No, not the red. Where's the pink one? Yo, we're gonna go all pink, my dudes. We're going all pink. For this island, we're going all pink. Order? Oh, order. Oh! Wait, fucking shit! That's the order cap that they had, because they had the order, whatchamacallit? Oh. They had the rest of the order stuff on the other island. We're gonna go all pink. Thunderbolt? Oh. Street cap. Sports cap? Oh, this is Bounce Suite! That's what it's supposed to be like! Oh, I get it! We're dressed like a Bounce Suite! Let's do it. Fuck it. Let's rock out. We're doing, we're going all pink this time around, my dudes. Mirrored sunglasses? Do we get sunglasses? Are we doing this? I don't want mirrored sunglasses. I don't know. I don't like the glasses. I'm not rocking with the glasses. Yep, let's do it. Let's do it. We had all white on the first island, then we had the Alolan muck all black on the second island, and now we in here like a Bounce Suite, my dudes. We in here like a Bounce Suite, my dudes! I don't give a fuck. It's so wildly outrageous and different from anything I would do. Why not? Let's go with it. Why the fuck not? Let's go with it. I was popping. Just changing my hairstyle makes me feel like a whole new person. Don't you feel the same, though? I guess you can't see it with my hat on. Alright. Cool. You're cool. Wait, I can feel it. I can feel it. Poodle Pokemon with fluffy fur. I don't see them at all in Alola. My fingers are itching to trim fur fru so bad. Excuse me, by the way. And fur fru is a poodle? I didn't think it was a poodle. What? Oh, we need to go this way anyways. We're exploring the area. We need to go this way anyways. We gotta go to the library. Whirly Pearl. Instead of Poliwhirl, it's Whirly Pearl. Ha! I get it. I fucking get it. Mali Community Center. Experience a real community culture? Is that what it said? Oh shit, Whirly Pearl. Whirl. What's popping with you? Whether the sun shines or rain falls on me, I'll just keep on swaying to the rhythm. You're like a postal worker in this bitch. Oh, you're Primarina. It's starting to look like it likes you. No, it does. It really fucking does. Who is this kid? I never met this Trwin person, but they just beat me in a link battle. Are you a pirate? Are you a trial goer? You should take this then. Strange souvenir. Fuck it. Another one. That strange souvenir is made in the image of the guardian Tapu who protect our islands. Some people hold them as amulets, hoping the image of the Tapu will protect them. That's wild that they had a strange souvenir all the way back in X and Y. They knew that the next region was going to be Hawaii, or, yeah, based off Hawaii. That's wild. Hints in front of us the entire time. Maybe I'll add a Pokemon to my team that can use Sand Stream so I let my Probopass really fight to the fullest. Your Probopass is ugly! It's got a pretty dope cry, though. If you want to know about the weather, you're in the right place. This is Weather Glass. But you're a Pokemon trainer, aren't you? Then how about a quiz that takes weather into the arena of Pokemon battles? It will take a bit longer doing it like this, but I'll give you a reward if you can keep up. Looks like you have what it takes. Tell me, my good trainer, which item would you have a Pokemon hold if you want Rain Dance to last a long time? That would be a Damp Rock. Suck my damp dick. That's it, correct. If a Pokemon holding a Damp Rock uses Rain Dance, the rain will keep falling for 8 turns. But I'm not beaten yet! Next question. Which item would you have a Pokemon hold if you want Hail to last a long time? An Icy Rock! Suck my icy dick! That's it, correct. If a Pokemon holding an Icy Rock uses Hail, then Hail will keep falling for a whole 8 turns. But I've still got some HP in me. Next question. Which item would you have a Pokemon hold if you want Sunshine to go on for ages? A Heat Rock! Suck my heated dick! That's it, correct. If a Pokemon holding a Heat Rock uses a Sunny Day, then Sun will shine for 8 turns! But I'm still in this match! Next question. Which item would you have a Pokemon hold if you want a Sandstorm to last a long time? A Smooth Rock. Suck my smooth dick. That's it, correct. If a Pokemon holding a smooth rock uses Sandstorm, the storm will rage for 8 turns. The most important part of any education is putting it to work in the real world. But it's not enough to understand in your head. You've got to know it in your bones. That's why I'll give you this set of rocks I've collected for your own use. An icy rock. A smooth rock. A heat rock. What could the last one be? Rock! Hot fucking damn! There are lots of ways to use the weather to your advantage in battle, so give it a try. Like, you could use rain to power up your water type moves or to weaken fire type moves that someone might use against you, or you could call a sandstorm to deal damage every turn to any Pokemon that isn't a rock, ground, or steel type. Oh! I'm glad I passed that class, but you know, then again, I am a fucking Pokemon master, so suck on my asshole. I was fishing in Pony Island the other day, and I managed to reel in a bottle cap. The two peaks that tower over Ulaula are Mount Hakulani and Mount Lanikila. Mount Lanikila is so tall that snow falls on its sides even in the summer. Speaking of, what was that Delmize Pokemon they were talking about? I find a shiny stone, but what should I do with it? I don't have a Floetta or Resilient, anyone that can use it. Give it to me. Welcome. Oh, it's the flea market? Can you buy stones here? Oh, shit. I feel like Rare Long Neck and Rare Order... Are these, like, shiny versions? I was gonna say, I feel like that changes based on the day of the week, like, what she offers. Like, today is just caps, maybe? I don't know. If only I had an omelet coin and let my Pokemon carry into battles, I'd get double the prize money. Well, sucks to be fucking you, doesn't it? You know, I had a piece of this candy I used to love and thought it seemed so small now. It was the first time I realized I was growing up. Oh, I don't care. Okay, so that's dope. So we've explored most of Mali City. I guess it really isn't as big as whatchamacallit. Oh well. Oh well. What's poppin' with you, young Lily?
Nappy! I'm sorry. I ended up getting lost yet again. I wandered around completely lost until I ducked into the apparel shop. Then I saw this outfit, and they said it was the last one they had in stock, so I bought it, even though I don't think I ever had the guts to wear an outfit like it. Huh?
Oh shit, look who it is!
But the woman working at the store did tell me where to find the library, so I guess you could say it was all for the best. Though the library is actually right past the apparel store if I just kept going.
Oh shit! What's poppin' with you, young Mudsdale?
Ah!
Nappy, been a while, friend. Looks like your island challenge is coming along favorably. It must be pleasing to the Tapu. So, Nappy, who might this skinny-haired, blonde-haired wench be?
Oh, hello. My name is Lily.
My apologies if Mudsdale spooked you just now. But it doesn't seem like you're a trial goer, so what the hell are you up to?
Oh, I'm, actually,
studying the Tapu's ruins for, various reasons of my own.
Well, that's some fine initiative. I'd be happy to show you the way whenever you like to go. My mud's there here is as sturdy as I'll get out. She can easily carry too.
Oh god, is Hapu a lesbian and she's hitting on Lily?
Thank you for your offer.
Yeah, come on. Sit on my mud's there right here. I'm a fan of arts and crafts. You know, scissoring and glue sticks and whatnot.
Shall we check out Madeline Library first, though, since we're here?
Lead the way. Lead the way, Lily.
Oh, shit. A dope-ass fucking library.
Yo, look at us in all pink. Why did I do that?
The book that I'm looking for is a very old one. It's a book that contains old myths and legends that Professor Burnett told me about. Those tales seem to suggest that Alola's legendary Pokemon came from another world.
Is it time for Mythbusters?
Didn't Lily say she'd be upstairs, or am I just hearing things?
I think Lily said that we're gonna save our game right here and wrap up today's episode. Hot fucking damn. So if you guys enjoyed today's episode and all of its Hour of Power glory, and of course if you're a proud member of the Happy Nation, make sure you smash the like button down below for us, because you already know you're supposed to greatly appreciate it. And of course, you know, can't nobody Let's Play a Game with the motherfucking Happy Nation. Let's Play a Game. Next episode, we'll clear out the library and I guess catch the bus to our first trial on Ula Ula Island. Swag, bitch. Thank you always for your support. Thank you for watching the video, but we out this bitch. Bye!